To my dearest Keith, this journey into love is almost like a trip into the unknown. Almost because I have the feeling that somehow I've been over this road before. The last time I made the trip alone, I remember some of the rough terrain and the potholes, the wild branches and slippery rocks that are moistened with tears. So this time I will walk carefully, watching my every step. I'll take your hand and lead you and guide you, but first you must give me trust and be ready to help me if I slip or fall, or suddenly I'm not able to see. For us, love is more than saying hello and later goodbye. Our love did not begin just to end. We have built a love very different from any we have ever experienced before, and the only thought we have about tomorrow is the continuation of today. We have both traveled through loneliness and sadness to this place of understanding, our place of beauty, and where we can continue growing together. It's the magic of dreams. We make our own magic with us, you and I. Places we have been, pay people we have met, and things we have done. Do you remember the bed that sagged like a hammock? The room in Tiffindale next to the snow machine? The Irish bedroom on the golf course? Do you remember the long walk to the bus stop and back to the hotel when we found out in fact we were right in front of it? The first time we visited a game farm, went on a train, and of course forgot to put film in the camera so half our trip wasn't recorded. Strange breakfasts, stranger suppers. Do you remember the night we fell out of bed in Sabi? Do you remember when you told me that Debbie, your sister, was getting a new leg? I didn't know she was missing one in the first place. It was funny the first time we went out of town and didn't have enough money to pay for a drink, so we told them we were allergic to bottled water. Magic, all magic. The memories to treasure all our days. I love you for the smallest things, holding flowers at the entrance to the airport when I get back from overseas. The Seattle coffee shop with hazelnut latte while reading the paper on a Sunday. Of course, taking the dog in the car and doing the 702 fun walk with him so you could see the other doggies. Driving the whole way to the West Coast so that I could visit my friend for 3 days. Letting me phone Natalie in Ireland in the middle of the night because she's having a panic attack and I need to be there for her. Buying me a ticket to Dublin when you knew she was ill and my world was falling apart. Letting me know that you have Matthew when you fetch him from school, and watching patiently while him and I play Crash on the PlayStation with games that you bought us in Australia. The way your eyes turn steely blue when you're angry and softening when we tell each other we're sorry. Coming home from work, cook, and then do the dishes and then watch my favorite love story with me on TV just because you love me. Holding me up when I took the wrong sleeping pill before getting on a plane to England so that no one would notice there was something wrong with me. Of course, going to see Shrek at the drive-in and freezing to death because it made me laugh was the best part. But the best part is in never leaving the house without kissing me goodbye, telling me you love me, and then SMSing me on the way to work to remind me how much you love me. And for the big things, giving me all the best things in your life, sharing my joys, being kind to me in all my failings, and giving me courage. Wherever I've needed someone to share my joy or someone to hold me when my world rips to pieces, you're there. I know you will be, tomorrow and always. We are busy people, you and I. To accomplish what we do, we have to stave off all distractions and give up many special pleasures for the work that we do. But our love is always there, true, constant and sure. Success or failure will hardly touch us. If whatever we do falls apart at the seams, you will still be there. These days of freedom, you can be anywhere. Long silver beaches, roaring fireplaces, elephants against the skyline, churches resonant with song, merry-go-rounds and coral reefs, a rambling farmhouse in Duas Caspors. But always at the heart of them, a quiet room, high-ceilinged, bright with sunlight, and you. I feel that somehow the whole adventure of existence has been justified by my having met you. You give me thoughtful gifts, wimpy coffee, Turkish delight, attachments for my camera, a mean Mr. Mustard album with my favorite song, Build Me a Buttercup, and of course red carnations for my bedside table, never forgetting earrings from Tanzania, a bracelet from Ghana, and of course my yellow Crocs from Australia. When you take me and Mr. McDuff for a surprise walk through the park with your grandchildren, they're a really good reason to marry you. But the best thing is when I surprise you deep at work, or you spot me in a crowd and your eyes light up with pleasure, and your smile stretches across the creases in your face. For me, the nicest thing is to know how much you love me. And to know to how many people you are a friend. Wealth is how much you love and how much love you have to give. And of course, loving someone is part of today's fortune of being able to give. I love you, and I'm very rich indeed. I love you, and there's nothing else in life I need. Sensual pleasure passes and vanishes in the twinkling of an eye. But the friendship between us, the mutual confidence, the delights of the heart, and the enchantment of the soul, these things do not perish and can never be destroyed. There is only one happiness in life, and that is to love and to be loved. Keith, I do, until you're 100 and I'm 99, together until our white hair grows.